Get back to the politics. So President Mahama is fine in the spirit. Could the people who are behind him overtake him between now and November 7th?
That is their personal relationship with God.
If they build their personal relationship with God, they can overtake.
But where, whatever the Lord is showing me, and I'm telling you, whatever the Lord is showing me, the man is very fine in the spirit.
Okay, so when people give us prophecy, coming back to Abeku's question, one says in 2008, there were a lot of prophecies.
Yeah.
Some of the prophecies didn't turn out to be right. Does it mean that those who prophesied and the prophecy turned out to be wrong are false prophets?
No.
Why?
Number two, let me show you this. Every prophetic, God has got a different way. Is it not the same God who told them, he told Moses, he said that I am taking you to the land, you and the people. But Moses could not arrive on the land. So does it mean that God was a false prophet? Number one, no. I'm coming. Was it not God who said that Samson, when he was about to be born, there was a word of the Lord concerning Samson, that it's going to be this, it's going to be that. But Samson could not fulfill. Now, the prophecy is given to you, and your individual relationship with God begin to say much concerning the prophetic.
Okay, now, so your personal relationship with God is very important, to build whatever prophecy that God has spoken about you. So God can say that you will be president.
Yes.
But if you don't build that personal relationship with him, you will not become.
You can't. There are people that...
So you can be born president.
Yes.
But if you don't build a relationship with
God,
you
can lose.
You will never become.
You can lose.
Or you can become later.
What later? You can even lose it. And that is what is about to happen. There will be a major shock in this nation.
My producer is asking me to ask you whether you can give us examples of flag bearers who don't have a relationship with God.
Flag bearers?
Yes.
That they don't have a relationship with God.
Name them.
I should name them.
Yes.
Okay, Paul. oh, my God. Paul, let me say this to you. Well,
okay, whilst you think about it, Robert Coleman.
I'm not thinking about it.
Robert Coleman of Zoom Lion is watching us. Robert, thank you very much for watching. Abeku says he's enjoying everything they are saying. Yeah, he's a director of communications for the Zoom Lion group.
Okay.
Anyway, so go on now.
Well,
show us those flag bearers who don't have it. You said President Mahama does, and he's fine in the spirit because of that. Uh-huh. Show us those who don't.
Those that they don't.
Or those who need to cover ground.
I would say that everybody needs to cover their
all ground. The rest.
Everybody.
You said Indum, you talk about Indum. Does Indum have a relationship with God?
Oh, why not? Nana Akufo-Addo also has a relationship with God. You get what I mean?
Yeah.
Everyone has got their relationship with God.
Let's come back to Usu Bempe's prophecy. Okay. He said that Nana Akufo-Addo has the keys.
Okay.
And if he lifts up until the election day, no one can take the victory from him.
Wow.
That's what he said.
That's what
Usu Bempe said.
Okay.
That Nana Akufo-Addo has the keys.
That is what
but he gave
what,
a condition.
That is what the Lord have told
that
him.
That if he has to help himself to live because people want him to die. But if he lives up until the election day, which has now been announced as November 7th, no one can take the victory from him.
Let me say this to you. This is the word of the Lord the Lord gave to Prophet Usu Bempe.
Yeah, that's what he said.
I respect my boss. I respect my senior prophet. Mm-hmm. But to me, that is not what the Lord have revealed to me. Even though that the prophet have seen it, it doesn't mean that all prophets must see the same thing at the same time.
But if it's God working.
No.
God is one, doesn't it?
God is one, but let me tell
that's
you.
That's Abeku's problem. Somebody, but, two prophets,
but
somebody
can
says
I, can I even...
Yeah,
I
we mean, are wrapping up
can
now.
Can I
this
even
thing,
clarify no? my question?
You come and I'll come back.
You, men of God, says that God reveals...
To redeem.
To redeem.
Okay. Yes,
so
amen.
Assuming God has revealed that this person is going to lose, and he comes and says that, please, man of God, intercede on my behalf and tell God to reverse the prophecy. Is there a possibility?
Hear me. You don't need even the man of God. You don't need the man of God. You don't need to go to the man of God and say that man of God reverse it. Now, when Hezekiah received the prophecy, he's going to die. He left the man of God alone.
And went to the wall.
He went to the wall.
To
because
pray.
That is where the personal relationship matters.
I see what you are saying.
I am not going to church because deep. I need the vote. I am not going, I'm not coming to your church. Your heart. There is no genuineness of relationship between you and your God. And you are coming to my church that because election is coming, I want to win the apathy and the sympathy. No.
So you have to hit the wall.
What are you talking about?
Pray to God.
And that is what I'm showing you.
You have to know the Lord.
This man sitting on the throne, there is something that he has got and is between him and his God.